Hello everyone, welcome to the thought topic in this unit 1, that is aberrations. Last class we discussed about the topic chromatic aberration. Now we will discuss about the elimination of chromatic aberration, that means methods for minimizing or complete elimination of chromatic aberration. In this chromatic aberration elimination, first and foremost achromatic doublet is used. This achromatic doublet is used for minimizing the chromatic aberration. In this system, imagine a convex lens having f1 focal length and omega 1 dispersive power of the lens. The chromatic aberration for convex lens is always positive. Now consider a concave lens having f2 focal length and omega 2 dispersive power. We know that chromatic aberration for concave lens is always negative. That means a suitable combination of different materials of convex and concave lenses can minimize the chromatic aberration. Hence we know that the effective focal length for two contact lenses is 1 by capital F is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. Here capital F is the effective focal length. Assume that this is one equation. Now differentiate the above equation on both sides. So we can write as implies minus df by f square is equal to minus df1 by f1 square minus df2 by f2 square. Because the differentiation of 1 by x gives the minus 1 by x square dx. So I have written the second equation basing on simple differentiation formula. Now cancel minus sign on both sides. Therefore we can write as df by capital F square is equal to df1 by f1 square plus df2 by f2 square. Assume this is a third equation. This third equation can be written as like d capital F by f square is equal to df1 by f1 into 1 by f1 plus df2 by f2 into 1 by f2. Therefore, the above equation we can write as a d capital F by f square is equal to omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2. Assuming this is a fifth equation, here omega is equal to df by f called dispersive power formula. So that equation we put in the above equation. But we know that the condition for achromatic doublet is d capital F becomes 0. Then only one white light ray could emerge from this system and forms a single colored image. Hence put df is equal to 0 in the above equation. Therefore we can write as a 0 is equal to omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2. Assume this is a sixth equation. Now rearrange the above equation. So minus f1 by f2 is equal to omega 1 by omega 2. Assuming that this is a seventh equation. This equation 7 is called the condition for the achromatic doublet. Hence, the ratio between two focal lengths of two lenses are equal to the ratio between their dispersive powers. Then this combination is called achromatic doublet. Here, minus sign indicates one must be convex lens and another must be concave lens. Because the dispersive powers of the lenses are omega 1 and omega 2, should not get negative sign at all. Hence from seventh equation, when a convex lens is made with a crown glass material and concave lens is made with a flint glass material, both are in contact with each other, then the system can minimize the chromatic aberration. So this combination is known as achromatic doublet. The second method is achromatic combination. Consider one convex lens having focal length f1 and dispersive power omega 1, and consider another convex lens having focal length f2 and dispersive power omega 2, assuming that both are separated by distance x. When the system is illuminated with white light ray which is incident on the first lens, then the light rays split into 7 colors. When these 7 colors are incident on second lens and forms a single white light ray image on the principal axis, then the system completely eliminates chromatic aberration. So the condition for achromatic combination is D into capital F is equal to 0. When two lenses are separated by some distance, then the effective focal length is 1 by capital F is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2 minus X by F1 F2. Here, X is the distance between two lenses. Assume this is the 8th equation. Here the extra term in the equation 8 is X by F1 F2 can be differentiated on UV method. Now differentiate the 8th equation on both sides implies minus d capital F by capital F square is equal to minus d F1 by F1 square minus d F2 by F2 square minus x into 1 by F1 into minus d F2 by F2 square plus 1 by F2 into minus d F1 by F1 square will come. Assuming this is 9th equation, solve the 9th equation, then we can write as a minus d capital F by capital F square is equal to minus d F1 by F1 square minus d F2 by F2 square plus x by F1 F2 into d F2 by F2 plus x by F1 F2 into d F1 by F1 will come. Implies minus d capital F by F square is equal to minus omega 1 by F1 minus omega 2 by F2 plus x by F1 F2 into omega 1 plus omega 2. Assume this is the 11th equation. Since from the formula omega is equal to d F by F, it is called as the dispersive power of the lens. Hence, this expression we put in the above equation. That's why we get 11th equation. But the condition for achromatic combination is d capital F is equal to 0. Put this in 11th equation, then we can write as a 0 is equal to minus omega 1 by F1 minus omega 2 by F2 plus x by F1 F2 into omega 1 plus omega 2. Therefore, omega 1 by F1 plus omega 2 by F2 is equal to x by F1 F2 into omega 1 plus omega 2. Assume this is 12th equation. Solve the 12th equation. So LHS of 12th equation LCM becomes F1 F2. So the above equation can be written as omega 1 F2 plus omega 2 F1 by F1 F2 is equal to x by F1 F2 into omega 1 plus omega 2. Assume that this is a 13th equation. Cancel F1 F2 on both sides in the denominator. Then 13th equation becomes x is equal to omega 1 F2 plus omega 2 F1 by omega 1 plus omega 2. Assume this is 14th equation. For example, the two convex lenses are made up of with same material, then omega 1 is equal to omega 2 is equal to omega. Put the above analogy in 14th equation. Therefore, x is equal to omega into F1 plus F2 divided by 2 omega. Therefore, the above equation can be written as x is equal to F1 plus F2 by 2. Assume this is 15th equation. Hence, when the two convex lenses are made up of with the same material, then these two lenses are separated with a distance is equal to the average of their focal lengths of the lenses, then this combination is called achromatic combination. So this system can completely eliminate chromatic aberration. This condition used in construction of Huygens eyepiece. So this is our topic. So please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.